most chefs, and vegetarians included, the risotto is always a great standby. But why always do the same thing with rice? We're going to prepare a Japanese buckwheat risotto with wild mushrooms and tempeh. First thing we need to do is get that mushroom stock going. So always all our trimmings from our mushrooms, and they're going into our stock. We need to prepare the mushrooms for the dish itself. So I'm just going to literally slice them down. But you say you could use any type of mushroom you wanted. If you wanted to use a button mushroom or a portobello, that works equally as well. So I've got a pan on the stove here. I'm adding a little bit of sunflower oil or rapeseed oil. So we're just going to get that warmed up. We're going to add our chopped onion. I'm going to add a little bit of grated ginger. And we're literally just going to get that going. And what happens is the vegetables, the onions, the ginger, the spice will begin to really wilt down and slightly become sweeter. And we want to call them, what you call it in the trade, we call to soften to etouffee. Just really sweat them down and get extract all the maximum flavour. I'm going to add our mushrooms now, which we've just literally sliced off as we dumped earlier. And we're going to add those to the onions and the ginger. What we're doing again, we don't want any colour. We want to literally just have a nice sweated mushroom and the onions, everything all keeping nice and white, but extracting all their maximum flavours. Okay, so here's our stock, which has been cooking about 20 minutes. We've really extracted all the flavour of those stalks now. So we're just going to strain that off, and that gives us a beautiful base for our risotto. There's our mushrooms inside there. See, they're beautiful. They've taken a little bit of colour now, but the onions are still lovely and white. I'm going to start adding some of the stock, a little bit ladle at a time, one and a half ladles at a time, to the mushrooms. And I like to get that going there, just get the flavour back into that before I add my buckwheat. So I'm just going to add that now, my buckwheat, to the base. And literally all we're doing now is to give that a good mix in. The idea of a risotto is that when you're actually adding when you're making a rice risotto, is to add a little bit of stock, let it reduce down, take on those flavours, add some more stock, let it go down again. Okay, so I've added all my stock now, all my beautiful flavoured mushroom stock, and the buckwheat is looking, smelling fantastic. I'm just going to push that to one side. Now, show you about this tempeh. I'm just going to cut it into little thin slices, basically. I'm going to take a little bit of butter in a pan, and I'm going to add our tempeh to the pan. I'm just going to get a slight bit of colour on this in my little bit of butter, and then I'm going to do a little glaze of the soy. Just add a little bit of our very thick soy. Literally glaze that in the soy. That really adds another dimension. I'm just going to leave that keeping warm on the side. I've just finished the risotto now. Bring our risotto back to the heat. Second, and what I want to add now is a little bit of mirin, which is like a sake, used sake. A bit of rice wine here. This is a little bit of mirin. Again, this is adding a little of acidity to the dish. And again, what we need to do is to add in some butter. Pull it off the heat. I'm just going to add in some butter. Quite a lot, because you want to literally bring this whole thing together. And that's what makes the secret of a good risotto, is the creaminess of the butter in it. And literally just literally stir that around. Brings the whole things together beautifully. A little bit of salt, touch of pepper, not too much, and we're literally ready to go. And then I'm going to take our risotto, nice amount of mushrooms in there, just getting quite rich, so you're not looking for a big portion as such. We can then take some of our little glazed tempeh just on the top. We can then just take a little bit of our beautiful, lovely baby coriander leaves. And there you have a little Japanese inspired buckwheat risotto, wild mushrooms. Again, forget the rice, get the buckwheat out, try something different. Japanese buckwheat risotto.